I hear succubi about. Be ready.
What's that?
Solid ground, the advantage is ours.
Hobbies will snatch you and fly.
Are they not hobbies?
Any that were dead of the arisen am I.
I've learned a new way to fight them.
Rain steel upon it!
I'll take that.
There's no way we could have lost to that.
This will restore a bit of health.
Shall restore your health. Hold on.
What's that?
It is my duty to share this journey with you. And an honor to serve.
It only gets tougher from here, Master. This looks interesting. What's this?
There's no way we could have lost to that.
Shall restore your health. Hold on.
Leave it to me.
What's that? This looks interesting.
Interesting. inside.
It is my duty to share this journey.
I've learned the contents of this book.
I've learned a new way to fight their ilk. What's this? This looks interesting.
Chimera!
New techniques against that foe. but a scratch.
I cannot do much more! lion is doing its magic.
Stay away from the lion. Its claws are sharp.
Mind your business.
I'll attack the lion.
I'll take the lead.
Lion fears magic.
I cannot take much more!
from the lion. Its claws are sharp.
Hit it with all your might!
Serpent first.
Just being at your side fills this pawn with vigor, Arisen.
The world we knew is... but a single leaf upon a vast tree.
My strength fails me.
Understood.
This will return us to the surface.
Yes, at last. At last you've gathered the whole of them. With them, you can summon forth a rift of considerable power. This rift, born of the Wakestone's power, will guide you forward, Arisen. I fear there will be no returning to this place. Are you prepared to journey on? End this, Arisen. May the world be put right by your hand.
Well met, Arisen. I'll not waste time on rhetoric. Defeat me, and take my place as keeper of this world. You saw it awaiting you at the end of your descent. Aye, the same world you've traveled to arrive at this place. A world you may well now inherit. It is a simple proposition. No different than any you've faced. You need only the will to claim what is offered you. The will to survive. Yes, fight, Arisen, as you e'er have fought in coming here. What is it that impels you? What force spurs you on? What sustained your wanderings and led you here? I ask, what is it that makes you alive? 'Tis volition, unbending will. You are here because you willed it, Arisen. That alone has brought you here. Potential. Just as you call forth pawns, so I command all life into existence. Call it divine creation if you must, but expect none of the mercy men seek in their gods. This is cold truth, the unbending reality of a world without compassion. The world and all its denizens are but empty vessels. In that regard, no different than the pawns. Without volition, there is no true life. The world falls stagnant, dead as an ocean with no current to guide it. That volition is tempered by the struggle for survival. The decision, just like yours, to fight. Just as the pawns need a master's command, so the world thirsts for the will to live. Let us continue, Arisen. Show that you are more than an empty vessel, animated by forces unseen. Show that the temper of your soul is strong enough to command far more than mere pawns. Show that your will is fit to bind the fraying circle of this world and hold it fast. Fight tooth and claw, struggle now and cling to life. Show that living holds worth enough to fight for. It is time to decide. Will you claim your right as Arisen? Or shrug the burden and seek peace in oblivion? Just so. One foot after the next, come what may. That is what it means to live. Turn back now and I will grant you a merciful death. The choice is yours, Arisen. Yours alone. Tis a simple choice, Arisen. Step forward or retreat. Accept the quiet emptiness of a false peace, a false life.
Put an end to it. Praises of the quiet life are sung far too infrequent. That's a mite harsh, aye? Ever the noble one, you.
You're not without a home to return to.
An honor for one of my stature.
Why this hesitation, sir? You've ought to protect, do you not?
This is your answer, then.
I would beg you rest a while, but just as like you would turn deaf ear. Instead, I ask only that you keep us in mind now and again.
I was always so afraid. You seemed to elect to leave for somewhere I could not follow. All I asked was to leave the side of those I love. All I ever asked.
You are crazy.
close now. So very close to me.
Come, Arisen. I shall meet you on your own terms, joined by my own companions alone. You stand now at its end, Arisen. See your journey through.
I feel a tremendous power.
It repeats upon itself, and all the world will repeat with it.
I've got it!
And so the cycle continues. Arisen, forgive me. All I've done was to test your will. It is the fate of all, Arisen. You and I are swept up in the current, same as the rest. Each tempers the volition of the next, and the endless cycle continues. And so, until the coming of a new soul fit to craft the will to live, someone like you. Until that day, may you guide the world ever justly. I present you with the Godsbane Blade. Those who arise to oversee this world are undying, save by this brand's kiss. I ask that you, as the world's new seneschal, use it now to vouchsafe freedom to your weary servant.
This bears the look of... the world beyond the rift.
New crown, sovereign and keeper of eternity. Grant me now this single boon. The fire of my life is spent in guttering. Give me freedom with the kiss of the Godspeed Blade. If there is aught you wish to know afore my death, you need but ask. My knowledge, as my all, is yours to take. What would you hear of me? The Seneschal is steward to the world. The world you traveled now rests in your care. Just as the Arisen calls Pawn into being and sets them to motion, the Seneschal holds dominion over all living things. There are those who would call such a being Maker or God. I cannot deny the claim any more than affirm it. In the end, they are but words. Call it what you will. Such is the office I have served, just as those before me and you beyond unto eternity.
It feels different, yet it seems a special place, a forgotten one.
New crown, sovereign. The fire of my... If there is aught, my knowledge, as my all. The pawns exist astride the rift. They speak of a multitude of worlds, each infinite unto itself. Limitless in span and lost to time. These worlds extend in an eternal, perfect loop. Just as a ring lacks start and end, so this world has no origin, no final terminus. If it does, they lie beyond our ken. We are prisoners of unpassing time, wandering an unending land. What lies beyond, we cannot know.
Rifts are but gateways.
New crown, sovereign. If there is my knowledge, aye. There is life in the world, and with it death. Naught lasts forever. Each rises and falls in its time. But such is a death akin to that of pawns. Appear in this world and vanish, only to appear again, like bubbles in a mountain spring. As so it is with all that lives within this eternal world. In time, you will come to see it happen under your watch, Asisha. Each beast, each blade of grass, each human life is born to die and be born again in endless rhythm. Naught lasts forever, yet all persists unto eternity.
Even we who traverse the rift do not ken what...
Newcrown, if there is aught, my knowledge, will is that which led you to this place, and that which turns the eternal wheel of the world. Along the endless string of life and death, there are some born with a hunger. They yearn for some other, better place. They are the Arisen, nascent fountainheads of will. And so the dragon is sent into the world to guide the Arisen and refine them, to temper their wills into aught capable of sustaining the world. And so the cycle of our world has e'er continued. New Crown Sovereign. If there is aught you wish to know. Mourn me not, for I welcome the release. At long last, I am free of eternity, of infinity, free of the cruel, unending ring.
Sense a strange power. It seems somehow familiar.
I'd given up hope of seeing you again, in any form. It's clear that forces beyond my ken are at work here. But I'll ask no questions. Not today.